My name is Satish Acharya. I'm a cartoonist. To start with, as a tradition, I will take the name of the god. Just imagine if Sachin Tendulkar was not allowed to take the less traveled road. So I'll try to put him in a different profession. So I've been asked to share my experience of taking a less traveled road. As a cartoonist, I'm more comfortable behind a drawing board. Normally cartoonists speak through cartoons. And they feel that cartooning is a more effective communication tool. But I was very keen to share my experience also, just hoping that it would help somebody who is at the career junction to take the right decision. Hope I won't end up discouraging or scaring those people. So we conveniently divide our career choices into less travel road and the much travel road. So what is the difference? I try to simplify the difference through a cartoon. So this is the less travel road. It's a jungle out there. It's almost like it's taken from Ram Gopal Varma's movie. Apparently he's also taken a less travel road. So it's scary, it's uncertain, it has threats, it has lots of setbacks, it has temporary failures. So what do you need to travel in this road? You need almost everything. Apart from all these things, you need persistence, you need a strong passion, and you need the ability to put lots of hours to excel in your skills. And you need lots of persistence, I said, and patience also, and some family support. So let's look at the other road, the much traveled road. It's a very familiar road. I mean, it's like more like a well-developed city. And you get everything there. I'll call it safe bets street. And you have lots of success stories who have taken this road. So it's easy to take also. And even our education system and even our society encourages us to take this road. So what do you need here? Just a MasterCard. Sorry for promoting MasterCard. As I said, I'm a professional cartoonist. I earn my living by drawing editorial cartoons. What is an editorial cartoon? There are things like illustrations, there are caricatures, there are comic strips. But editorial cartooning is different. Editorial cartooning is a comment made by the cartoonist on a news topic or a current affair event through humorous illustrations. Here are some of my editorial cartoons. This was done when Malala was shot. This was during Arvind Kejriwal's Dharna. And this was during that attack at ATM. Quite sad, but I had to express my opinion also. Though I am an MBA, I proudly call myself a professional cartoonist. And I am married to a doctor who is a medical professional. But the difference is she is trained for the job, but I am not trained for the job. But in the family, I am the one who gives the best medicine. Humor is the best medicine. So in every walk of life, we meet professionals like engineers, doctors, lawyers, chartered accountants, bankers, and management professionals who are all trained for the job. They have spent some years of their life getting trained to get into a job. But most of the editorial cartoonists, they are not trained. Maybe the one reason is editorial cartooning is not just one profession. It's a combination of three professions. There is a drawing part, which is art. And there is humor, which I call as satire. There is also a comment made by the cartoonist on a news item, which is definitely a part of journalism. There is another example. This was done after Dr. Kurian's death. if you look at many established cartoonists, they don't excel in all these areas. Personally, I try to strike a balance between all these three areas. Maybe someone like R.K. Lakshman, who is an exception. So how is a cartoonist is born? Basically, an editorial cartoonist. If you look at the career journey of many cartoonists, they are all ekalavyas. They learned their art by copying other cartoonists' work. And most probably the Dronacharyas are R.K. Lakshman's, Mario Miranda's, and Ajit Mainan's. So even my journey was not different. My first introduction to illustrations was through Amar Chitrakatha. The illustrations in Amar Chitrakatha made me understand the power of illustrations to tell a story. Later, the cartoons that used to appear in Illustrated Weekly of India, cartoons of R.K. Lakshman, Mario Miranda, I started copying them. Mostly the cartoons of R.K. Lakshman, because his cartoons were almost perfect. And gradually, I developed my own style. And I started contributing to Kannada local papers and magazines to earn my pocket money during holidays. But cartooning was never my career choice because I knew that it can never feed me. In fact, I wanted to be a cricketer. And at college, I took commerce to play for banks so that work for a bank so that I can play cricket. Because earlier, most of the cricketers used to play for banks. This is Syed Kirmani, who used to play for State Bank of India. Now the situation is different. I mean, after liberalization, now most of the cricketers are banks. And I did MBA in finance just for better job prospects. I think I took someone's job also. And my life changed after I went for an interview at Cadbury's. The marketing manager at Cadbury's who was taking my interview was also an MBA. He saw the passion in me towards cartooning. And he said something which I still remember. He said anybody can become an MBA, but not everyone can be a cartoonist. That comment was both ego buster and ego booster also. Ego buster because at MBA we were told we were the best. And ego booster because as a cartoonist I got some confidence. And my life changed after I went to Mumbai. I did some odd marketing jobs. I did work at some advertising agencies. But continuously I used to do freelance cartooning also. Because I was looking for just one opportunity to get into a newspaper to become a professional cartoonist. It took me 10 years. I couldn't focus on both the areas, both in my MBA job or in freelance cartooning. It was a long struggle of 10 years. And those 10 years taught me a lot about life also. Then in 2003, Midday happened. Midday is a newspaper in Mumbai. I got a break at Midday after 10 years. And thanks to the belief shown by the then editor Akar Patel, I got a cartoon column in the paper. I started doing daily cartoons for some 10 years. And at Midday, I learnt a lot about news also. I started looking at news differently. I started understanding news. And I learnt many things about media also. This is my Mumbai days. This is my learning experience with the media. So I was establishing as a cartoonist, professional cartoonist at Midday. I spent around 7-8 years there. And in 2010, they say old habits die hard. I took another risky decision. It was a much riskier one. I decided to relocate to my hometown in Kundapur from Mumbai. It was like uprooting a well-grown tree from a fertile Mumbai land and planting it in a desert. It was risky because I had a wife and I had a little son. I wanted to shift because of my son. He was suffering because of the pollution levels in Mumbai. And also I wanted to give him a better family life. So I shifted to Mumbai, Kundapur. But luckily, Facebook and Twitter, the social media, helped me reach more clients and helped me reach more readers also. And also helped me create my own space on the web, especially the Facebook. So that's been my journey as an editorial cartoonist. And now through Facebook and Twitter, I reach more people, more readers than some of the established newspapers. And I get immediate interaction, immediate feedback from the readers. And if you ask me if I have any regrets in choosing cartooning as a profession, there is none. Though sometimes I feel that maybe I was not good enough to any other job. These are the comments I get on Facebook, Twitter, for most of the cartoons. So I would definitely recommend to youngsters who wants to take up cartooning as a profession, but it's not for the faint-hearted people. I mean, you have to put in lots of hours, lots of years. You have to. There is no guarantee of success also, but if you are determined to succeed, you can succeed. Thank you.